Like, share, subscribe. Visit kahantazadaq.net. Become a secure creditor now.
But before we actually go into any questions, I actually wanted to actually touch on something. There's a lot of people that, you know, have questions actually regard to birth certificates and secure party creditor. If anyone have any questions regarding that tonight, we'll actually leave, you know, the room open for that. So we'll kind of make that the subject matter, like, you know, as far as becoming secure party creditor, so on and so forth. You know, which, you know, the criteria you need to go through and so on and so forth. Again, I don't know that Dr. Nicole is actually going to be coming on because, nevertheless, so I wanted to talk briefly about the birth certificate. Now, the birth certificate is considered a warranty deed. So I'm going to say that again. The birth certificate is considered to be a warranty deed, which is a bond, which is essentially why it's printed on bond paper, which is now, here's where people like Harvey Dent starts to go off. They start saying it's your estate. It's not your estate. It belongs to the straw man because the de facto creator, it's not your estate. It belongs to the straw man because the de facto created the straw man. You didn't create the straw man. Therefore, you can't own the straw man. However, you can control it if you know how to control the straw man. So, you know, let's totally understand that. I want to get that CFR 72.11. You know, you're dealing in commerce. You're always dealing in commerce. This is the system that this this man that's in power has actually set up. Now, so I would like to say, so the birth certificate is considered a warranty deed, which is a bond for its estate, because a straw man only exists on paper. It's dead. Is dead in the water, not for your estate, but its estate, which is actually funded by your parents at birth, usually the mother, usually the father, you know, his signature, not even really necessary. Now, this was actually amended in that Social Security Act in 1939, and it's actually, now here's an interesting thing to keep in mind. You know, the info that I'm about to give you. When you look at 50 U.S.C. 4305B, I'm going to say that again, and I'm actually going to post it in the room for the people that's actually, you know, actually online chatting. You know, if you sign up via website, then you could actually also see the chat because I post a lot of information in the room or type it in the room, however you want to say it. So that's 50 U.S.C. 4305B, Section 2. It says any payment, conveyance, transfer, assignment, or delivery of property or entrance therein made to or for the account of the United States or as otherwise directed pursuant to this subdivision or any rule, regulation, instruction, or direction issued hereunder shall to the extent thereof be a full acquaintance and discharge for all purposes of obligations of the persons making the same, and no person shall be liable in any court for it or any respect to anything done or omitted in good faith in connection with the administration of or in pursuance and in reliance on the subdivision or any rule, regulation, instructions, or direction issued hereunder. Now, why am I teaching you this? Because many of you, you're so damn weak. And I'm going to talk to you like this because you're friggin' weak. And I'm like exhausted with people kind of, oh, Tazadaq, this didn't work. They're issuing me a threat. They're sending a letter in my state saying that they're going to threat people for filing frivolous papers. Well, if you're not rooted in yourself, if you don't have any damn confidence, then you shouldn't be doing this anyways, man. What do you think? Do you think these people are going to sit down and tell you that what you're doing is true? If you don't have any strong root in yourself, they're going to tell you it's frivolous. And if you're simple ass, go for it, then there you go. But it's written right here in their statutory laws, 50 U.S.C. Now, you heard what I just read, 4305B. So you can't be held liable for any of this. All you have to do is show them the law. You don't go in, you argue with them over nothing. You just go in, show them the damn law, point blank, period. And that's it. What the hell you mean the acceptance of value don't work when it's worked for me plenty of times and other people that I've actually guided through the process? So don't tell me it doesn't work. It works for me every time. I contend that it's something that you're doing wrong. It's something that you're doing wrong. Now let's look at 31 U.S.C. 5118A. And I'm looking at paragraph 2 here also. And you should be writing these down. Because all of you that's doing acceptance of value for educational purposes only, I'm giving you extra ammo by your head. I'm giving you this for nothing. I'm giving you my time and energy for nothing. I'm not getting paid for these shows by that. I'm giving you love. So receive the love. So 31 U.S.C. 5118 Alpha, Section 2. Public debt obligation means a domestic obligation issued or guaranteed by the United States government to repay money or interest. Do you understand? So if they say you have a public debt obligation on the public side, who's supposed to pay it? According to 31 U.S.C. 5118A, Section 2, the United States government. Now get Donald Trump out of that. I'm giving you the law. So stop sending me all these damn bugged out damn emails because you don't want to study and you don't want to research the information that I've been telling you for years. It's right here. All you got to do is get the damn books like the brother Shenandoah was telling you. You know, if you get my books, man, you know how much information is in those books? If you sit down and take the damn time to read them and stop watching damn LeBron James. LeBron James don't give a damn about you, man. If you be home and see if LeBron James come and save your ass since you think he's King James. The only King James you need to be have an invested interest in is the damn, you know, King James Bible. That's it. LeBron James don't care about you. Xbox don't care about you. PlayStation don't care about you. You better get your minds right and get these books like we've been suggesting so you'll know this stuff that I don't have to go on here and do this. Because rightfully so, I could charge you for this because it requires my time and energy. I get person after person, oh, they get something for value don't work anymore. You fixing your big, thick Negro, Tazadaq, the acceptance for value don't work anymore. Yeah, it doesn't work for you because you don't know what the hell you're doing. I'm going to give you another one. I'm giving you U.S. codes. I'm showing you the law. So how do you defeat them? You don't argue with them. They tell you, oh, it doesn't work. This is frivolous papers, and you go into acquiescence. No, man, show them the law. Just show them the law and keep it moving. 31, write this one down. 31 U.S.C. 3123 Alpha. That's 31 U.S.C. 3123 Alpha. You really should be writing these codes down because you could use these as reference for any and every A for V that you're doing. So when I say alpha, I mean A. For those of you that don't understand the phonetic alphabet or you never served in the military. So the faith of the United States government is pledged to pay. Understand that. The faith of the United States government is pledged to pay in legal tender, principal, and interest on obligations of government issues under this chapter. Do you understand? So why are you telling me? You know what? You're listening to Esau. You're going out there and you're following Esau. You're following his paperwork. And things don't work the same way for them as it do for us. Understand that. We're indigenous to this land. So if you want to get remedy here, you use their laws or their statutory colorable laws against them. You show them the law. Don't be debating, arguing. Same thing. If you go into a colorable venue, you go in and you show them the damn law and you be out of there. That's it. Don't.
Click the link below. Become a secure creditor now. What are you waiting for? Shout out to Matthew Grant.